publishing is itself political, both as an author and also a publisher. As an author, you might be placing yourself on one side of an academic or political debate. As a series editor, your series might be taking a stand on representation in academia by promoting perspectives from and studies of understudied regions. Even the way that you publish can be political. At Palgrave, we offer open access as a model of publishing, which might be really important to you as an author. If you're wondering the type of research that I do, is it ethical to put it behind a paywall, or should it be accessible for everyone? These questions about the nature of academia and academic publishing are political, and they're questions that our authors face every day. As an editor, it's important that my list is apolitical, that it doesn't have the stamp of my personal politics. But on a personal level, what are the ethics of publishing work that you don't agree with politically, but might further academic discourse? Then there's the question of who decides what is furthering academic discourse? Who are the gatekeepers? Peer review is a core part of the academic process, and that's not going away anytime soon. But more and more academics have been questioning the system. The argument is that, like with most traditional institutions, peer review subtly or not so subtly reinforces the structural inequalities within academia. Peer review rewards the perspective of an elite segment of academia. So as an example, if you're a researcher at a top institution, you might have more funding for research and a lighter course load, which leads you to be able to publish more and establish yourself as a leading expert in a certain field. You can then take on graduate students and train them in your image, which reinforces a particular approach to a certain area of study. What does that mean if you're an academic who wants to come at those same research questions, but from a completely different perspective? It's also important to note that a lot of these top institutions are Western. How can open peer review, for instance, which welcomes feedback from all academics rather than just a select few experts, change the nature of academic discourse? This is why innovative peer review processes are under development across the industry and at Springer Nature as well.